All right, so here I am making another hideous "what is she wearing" video, but no, clothes are not, what do you call it, behaving. I don't know, figuring out this Excel sheet, and I've been going on and on and on. I think I've been working at it pretty steadily, and I've reached the point where I think it's absolutely actually giving information for taxations. So by the end of the year, you can pull out the tax data. So I'm very, very hyped with it. It's very cool. And that's including because here we have these 100 villages, and we have people paying the cooperative to swap houses. They want to move houses around. They don't want their house anymore. They want another house, and they have the even trades, or they have, well, that one's an upgrade, and so I'm going to pay a little extra. And so when they pay that little extra, they have to pay the cooperative. And so when they pay the cooperative, that goes into the tax books, this Excel thing. So I added that in there, and it's great. It's working all the way through to even the W-4 moment, when you get to, like, well, we're going to be the withholders as the main corporation. We're going to be the withholders of so not everybody in the cooperative 5,000 has to do taxes. That's the whole point of it. We prefer to have them all be our people. And when they are our people like that, much easier. So even though they buy that house initially for a small price, and then it builds, they build it, and then it's worth more in value. I'm kicking the 5,000s up to 50,000. Even though they're worth more in value after they're built, the people are still not having to be responsible for tax as a sole proprietor or as a contractor, those types of things, because I think that would be pretty dastardly. I included a yes or no in the sheet option, but I'm leaving it at yes. The corporation will be doing the withholding. I think that's the better way to solve the problem for everybody. So yeah, the cooperative corporation. So anyway, very cool. It's amazing. It's an amazing sheet, actually. And I did limit it to 5,000. I did matriculate it down to 5,000 rows. Now, that makes it a little bit bulky and on saves and those types of things, but it's still great. It's still great, and those pull down, those list things, sometimes they take some time to load, and then sometimes if you're going to another sheet, it may take time to load, so you just have to be a little bit calm about it, but it's there, and it's holding all the data for 5,000 already, minus just a few details, so it hasn't crashed. It's very, very safe and secure, not jumping out to the moon. So, so it's a pretty good one. I made the swap calculator, I fixed it. I made it really, really exact. What else did I do? The swap calculator, the sell calculator, added a sell sheet. Like, if you're going to sell a house and jump out of the cooperative, you don't want to be in it any longer, and a new villager is coming into the cooperative, then there's a sheet for that moment. It's really just a lot of copy that row, and you move it into another sheet as a text save, and then the data from the new person takes over your old row. So it's, and then you go back to the qualify row that you were in, and it becomes the new person. So that's how that works. So it's kind of a simple one, and I'm keeping all of the rows set. So there's no moving around, there's no sorting, they're just stagnant rows, 1 through 5,000, and there is no sorting, nothing like that. It's just the rows as is. So if you sign on and you become villager number 29, you're the 29th villager of all 5,000, you will always be on the 29th row, and that through all of the, through many, many of the sheets. So it's kind of fun, a fun little business. It looks like it's nonprofit. I would like to be a nonprofit. I think that would be very cool, but I don't know how that would go on. So yeah, so I think the sheet's good enough to really look at and make sense of it. I added a house number, a page, and that includes every, like if you're in village number 30 and you're the woo-woo 30s, every villager that's in woo-woo 30, so there's a regular list of those 50 people. And when I say 50 people, I mean the head of household. And I really prefer under 3 people per house. I think they're going to be so small and so tiny, these little houses that are being constructed, that it doesn't make sense to cram people in there. Okay. So yeah, it would be like just be like too much. So anyway, so that's where I'm at with the sheet is sheet. I would love to say it's self-explanatory, and I think it is. I think it looks self-explanatory to me anyway. But yeah. At least, you know, even if you're a sheet writer and you see it and you get the gist of what it is and the flow of how it is, you could write your own exactly your way and see if it's better. But I don't know. It's got a lot of bells and whistles. It has codes for this and codes for that and codes for the other. And so I did write a lot of the codes that help out in the pools. I did that the last few days. What else? Oh, and find out exactly how much, like that one person paid per year, like Lexi of Zimbo, he paid exactly that much in the year 2017, and that will go into the taxation page called earnings. So the earning page there is Zimbo, and he's there with his 30, whatever he paid, I can't remember, but yeah, he paid something. And then on the very first part of the sheet, just the numbers. I have just the numbers that were fed into the corporation, and then the numbers that were fed to one of the owners, because one of the owners is always paid if the house is more expensive. Okay, so that's the way it works. If the house is more pricey, the person who's moving up into the upgrade pays that owner, but instead of paying that owner directly, they pay the cooperative, and then the cooperative pays that owner. It's just, you know, the money chain handling thing. And I think that's it. I think I've got quite a bunch of it. Yeah, but I did notice, I think I wrote a lot this morning, and I think it's not good for my body physically, like I mean, I know it isn't. It hurts my upper back. I know it isn't. But I think for singing, it's not good at all, because you're sitting in this chair, and our stomachs are so important in singing. Her stomach, and it's just like, well, I was just like, I didn't have enough support today. I'm just sitting here like a typer human, you know. When you're sitting here like a typer human, I don't think that helps our singing voices. So, I don't know. I guess a warning before you sing: do something else, or lay down, or do something. You know, just don't look at the computer an hour or 2 hours before. I just think it does something to us. I think it just turns us into flumps. Once we've been turned into a flump, you know, it's just hard to push. It's hard to get all of the oxygen in, to get the oxygen out, you know, because that's what singing is. You know, you got to breathe in, breathe out, you know. So, yeah. Anyway, interesting. So what do I do in this chair? You know, where is the oxygen there? I just live on this little amount. Probably. We probably live off these little tiny breaths of consolidated small air, and we don't need a lot. You know what I mean? Anyway, so I know I look like a terrible hag today, but oh my gosh, it's wonderful. The sheet is great. And I'm just tired of it, and I'm tired of selling it even. I'm so tired of it being the writer. So anyway, so it does handle, it handles 100 villages, and it handles the prices of the different houses, their specialties. It has a village finder, like if it's a new person and they're like a musician and they have to be with other musicians, okay, it helps you find them. So it has a village finder. It has a username checker, so if a person wants to buy two houses or three houses, they become Zibbo 1, Zibbo 2, Zibbo 3. So it tells you, you already have that Zibbo, so it gives you the new one for Zibbo. It tells you to go to Zibbo 11 or whatever. So I made a username checker, and then what else did I do? Oh my gosh. And also, of course, if anybody has the exact same username, so it solves that question also. But it's kind of exciting. And now I'm looking at the taxes. I'm all bummed out because the $5,000 price looks so like beat up. It's beat up because everything was great. You know, mud is cheap, straw is cheap, sand is cheap, and then all of a sudden there's the tax man, and he's not cheap. I'm like, oh my God, he's just ruining. He's ruining everything. So, because he has to be paid now. And I said, that's not fair. Now, is it? That's not fair at all. Because it's such a low amount. That's why I was saying, you know, maybe if we can make it a nonprofit based upon these are built off of such a self-sustaining situation. Maybe if we can make the whole corporation, all 100 villages, non-profit, that would be key. That would be key in stopping that excessive take, because, whoa, you know, that's just too much. It's too much shock. What do you call a sticker shock out of the tax man? Oh, my God. Yeah. Anyway, so it's there.